I have lost 130 pounds and kept it off for 6 years. And often people will say, what do I do for exercise? What did you do in the beginning? I'm gonna tell you how I went from a size 24 to a size 5. I did it by walking, and I'm gonna tell you how much walking I did. In the beginning, I couldn't really do very much because I was so heavy. I was 275 pounds. I could barely bend down to tie my shoes. Walking upstairs, I got really out of breath. And I tried so many different ways of exercising. I tried challenges, I tried jump rope, I tried jogging, but nothing was really helping, especially at the size I was at. I couldn't really do much. So I decided to do something I liked and that I could do, which was walking. Walking was easier for me to do because I could sustain it longer by just doing as much as my body was capable of at all the different stages of my weight loss journey. When I first started out, I couldn't do much. So I started with 5 to 15 minutes. And every day I just got myself out there. Kyle, my husband, also, he was 375 pounds. So he needed to just walk too. The two of us walked every single day. We usually had to stop about every 5 minutes because we were getting leg cramps. I had plantar fasciitis really bad. And we just needed breaks. So we were really gentle on ourselves and we just gave ourselves those breaks. We walked 5 to 15 minutes every single day for the first little while. And after we lost our first 50 pounds, we started to notice our stamina was picking up. So to sum it up, the first phase, it was about 3 months. We lost 50 pounds in 3 months by eating in a calorie deficit with portion control and walking 5 to 15 minutes every single day. And because we had so much weight to lose, the weight fell off very quickly. So we lost 50 pounds in 3 months by portion control and walking. So when I started my weight loss journey of walking, I was a size 24. After I lost my first 50 pounds, I would say I was just starting to get around like a size 20 or so. And then the next phase was we could walk a little bit longer. So we usually would do about 20 to 45 minutes depending on the day, and always was steady state so that we could hold a conversation. We could feel our heart rate up, breathing a little bit heavy, but nothing that wasn't sustainable, just an easy pace that was enjoyable.
That's a good point too. I'll just chime in here. A lot of people ask us about HIIT training and all that stuff. Throughout our whole journey, like 6+ years, it's always been LISS, or low intensity steady state cardio, we find works the best, most sustainable. You can have a conversation, but your heart rate's a little elevated. Mm-hmm. And it's not to say we don't do sometimes, like Nicole said, pick up the pace on the bike or the walk or something, or do a little bit of jogging, but it's not the bulk of what we do.
Yeah, every once in a while we'll say, hey, let's just jog a little bit from this pole to this pole if we're walking outside.
And I'll beat Nicole in a race because I'm a lot faster and better at everything.
I beat him at the very beginning. I'm like, whoa, I'm in the lead, and then at the end he beats me.
So Nicole's quick off the start, but
yeah, I'm a bunny in the beginning and then a little bit of a turtle in the end, but that's okay. We enjoy it because we don't force it. It's what we enjoy and it's steady state, so you can sustain it. Every day we look forward to it because it was something we could do together. You could do it with your partner, or if you have kids, or if you have a pet, you can take your pet for a walk or walk with your kids. It's something that anyone can do.
So we used to think we were like Olympic athletes, and when we heard about HIIT, we're like,
let's do it.
Oh yeah, you mean I can burn 600 calories in 10 minutes?
In reality,
no.
Especially like at the size we were at in the beginning, we could not sustain that or burn many calories doing that. That's why we've always stuck with walking. We are not fit enough. Most people aren't, to be honest, fit enough to do HIIT and actually burn the calories that you can with HIIT, which is why we choose walking, because we love it. And it helps. And then we got into the next phase where we walk pretty much 20 to 45 minutes for the next year or so until we lost the rest of our weight. 130 pounds total each.
Yeah, it took about 2 years for us to lose the bulk of our weight.
And the reason why is because we chose to do it slower, but also we hit a plateau in the middle and then we also gained a little bit back. We sort of fell off track and then we had to get back on, lose what we had gained and move on. And that's okay, that's part of the journey. Everybody has mistakes where they fall off track, so don't be hard on yourself about that. And then once we lost the majority of our weight and we were like pretty happy with our body, but we were like, you know, let's see what we can do. Let's see if we can lean out and get even more fit.
Which means basically changing the composition of our bodies, holding on to muscle that we've built over the years while losing a bit of body fat.
Yeah, because we had chosen to build muscle after we lost our weight because we had a lot of loose skin. So the muscle filled out some of the loose skin. That way we didn't look so like floppy everywhere. Get a little floppy with loose skin. And then for the last 6 months, like 6 months ago, we were like, okay, let's see what our bodies can do. We've already lost a lot of weight. Can we make them look even better? So we decided to up our cardio to an hour of cardio 6 times a week. We do it pretty much every day except leg day, because on leg day, it's just, it won't really help your leg day. You'll
yeah.
already be so like, it'll take all your energy away and then you won't be able to give it on leg day.
And on leg day, we burn so many calories, we can eat Wendy's and large pizzas. Right, Greg?
No.
Greg loves that. So,
just kidding, don't do that. No. You don't actually burn a lot of calories in the gym.
No, but you won't be able to give a lot of energy if you've already worked your legs in cardio. You just won't, it'll just kind of not work. So that's why we don't do cardio on leg day. Then we do, like Kyle said, list low intensity, steady state cardio for an hour, 6 days a week. Sometimes that's the recumbent bike or the treadmill in our basement if the weather's not great. Most of the time we're outside walking and we do it for an hour and we didn't start there. So don't think, oh my gosh, these people do an hour. You don't have to start there. We started with 5 minutes. It's taken us, you know, this is the sixth year we've kept the weight off. We're doing an hour now.
This brings us to a good point. When you have a lot of weight to lose, the weight comes off you much easier.
Yeah.
So we're a lot smaller and leaner now. It's very hard to even drop 2 pounds now.
That's why, so we had to up the intensity of our cardio because we don't have the greatest genetics. So we had
Speak for yourself.
Okay, I don't have the greatest genetics. So if I wanted to get more fit, I need to do an hour of cardio, especially because I have PCOS. So it makes it a little bit harder for me to lose weight. I have to work a little harder. So I eat in a calorie deficit of 1900 calories right now, and I do an hour of cardio 6 days a week. I am the most fit I have ever been in my entire life. I can't even believe I just ordered and fit in a size 5 for the first time in my life. I'm 37 years old.
Ooh.
I'm 5'4" for those of you that want to know, and I'm about 145, 146 pounds right now. I have like ab lines coming in, and this is literally like I'm eating food, 1900 calories, and just walking an hour a day, and I love it. I look forward to walking every day, and when I see how fit I am, it motivates me to keep doing it, and I love it, and I love getting outside and connecting with nature. And just know, like, don't push yourself. Do what you love. You don't have to do anything crazy. You can eat the foods that you love as long as you're in a calorie deficit. That's all you need to do to lose weight. Eat a little bit less and move your body in a way that you love. If you love doing HIIT or jumping jacks or whatever, do it. That's cool. But if you don't, walking is all I have done. For 6 years, I've kept the weight off and I keep getting more fit and I've just been walking. Look at my new outfit, guys.
It's tie-dye, beautiful.
Thanks. So the friends, that is it. I went from a size 24 to a size 5 by walking. And I just went, I started with 5 minutes, worked my way up to an hour. So you can just work into it. Don't force yourself. Just do a little at a time. And that's it. We love you guys. We're here for you. If you want to know exactly what we ate to lose our first and next 50 pounds, check out down below the links to our weight loss guide, exact portions, exact meal plans, family-friendly recipes. Plus, we have 2 recipes in Power 13 Cookbook. Check those out too. Watch these 2 videos. You know what's coming next if you know the channel. We're gonna shake it till our mama's made it.
Whoa.
On for it up. We're really gonna need the Big Mac sass because these shorts are short.
Okay, I'll put a Big Mac because it's YouTube and we're PG over here.
Shake your beam and shake your beam. I can't really shake it because these shorts are short. Shake your beam and shake your beam. Oh, yeah. Whew. Love you guys. Peace out.
See ya.
Remember the friends that weight loss isn't just about the number on the scale. It's also about here and here. Heart and mindset. Fight through it. You can do it. Don't give up.